Hey guys, welcome back to Caveman Mining. Hope everyone is well and having a great day. On today's video, we are going to be testing out the hash rates for the new AMD 6600. And this card was released last week and we picked it up last week. Able to scoop this up from Micro Center the second day it was out. And we have our little test bench here. Just a small rig, one PSU, Intel i5, 8 gigs of RAM, and we have the card here hooked up and cranking away. So when we first tried to test this out, we actually had to swap the motherboards out, because I can show you on the ground, I have a little bit of a mess here, that I had this old Dell motherboard. It is a Core Duo. I believe the chipset is 700 series chipset, pretty old, probably about 2008 or 2007, that chipset, and we could not get the card to work on it. We were getting an error of code 43, and pretty much I did everything in my power to get it to work. Driver updates, chipset updates, BIOS updates, you name it, threw the book at it and couldn't get it to work. So for the sake of time, I did have another motherboard laying around, a little bit newer chipset, and yeah, connected right up, fired up, drivers worked, card ran and started hashing right away. So first things first, I want to get into the hash rate review of this card, and you can see we are mining Ethereum out the gate. So we're running NB miner 39.5, and we're pulling a hash rate of 29.12. okay, and we've got a couple, I just fired this up, so we get a couple of shares here, nothing rejected, three shares. And I want to show you my overclocks for Ethereum. So we've got a memory clock here of 1900, so you got to crank the memory way up. The core clock is at 1305. We leave the power limit at zero, and I've got the fans at 81%. So I've seen pretty much people with varying results getting into the 28s, high 27s, and mid to low 29s. Actually, I haven't seen anyone break the 30 mark on these cards yet. I'm still kind of trying to figure that out and play with it. But yeah, these were the best settings I could find for Ethereum. And pretty power efficient in the software. So you can see we've got 57 watts here. If we take a walk over to the Space Goat's power meter, and we'll do that right now, we will get the live at the wall reading. And if you guys can see here, we're pulling about 122 watts at the wall. So that could be because we've got the fan going. Could be too because I have my other rigs not powered on, but I still have the power connected. So let me go ahead and see if I can unplug the PSUs from those other rigs to see maybe that's interfacing with this a little bit. So give me just one second on that. We'll take a walk over here. We're gonna switch off the power supply on the back of this guy. We are going to unplug, and bear with me here. Just gonna take a little care. That power supply for the server power supply, we're gonna go around back of the rigs, and we're gonna stretch out over here, flip off this switch, flip off this switch, because we've got the two combined there. Let's see if that makes any difference at all, because that's all running into the same PDU. Even though we didn't have those rigs on, it could still make a little bit of a difference. And yeah, you can see now we dropped, well, yeah, we dropped to about 114, 115 watts at the wall. So that made a little bit of a difference. All right, guys, so we are now running Raven, and we're getting around mid 13s to low 13s in hash rate, 1320,
ranging to 1307 to 1311 to 1313 on there. And we look at our overclocks, we are at the core clock of 2605 and the memory all the way down to 1750 and our fan at 61% and our normal power level there. So clearly puts a little bit more strain on the card. We go way up in terms of pushing the core clock, but not too bad. I've seen some better results in HiveOS, so hopefully when we do some tests in Hive on this card, we'll get into the 14 mega hash range. But let's take a look at the power in the software. We're sitting at 99 watts, so that's fine. But let's take a walk over again to the wall and see what we have at the wall. It's going to be clearly higher than before, and we have around 164, 165 watts at the wall running Raven coins. So let's do one last quick test. We're going to test out the hash rate on Ergo, and we'll conclude with some thoughts. All right, so we are now running Ergo and actually doing pretty darn good in terms of hash rate. Probably one of the higher hash rates I've seen thus far on Ergo. So we've got 55.98. We'll see if we can get a little bit higher there, 55.86. Power level running at 90 watts in the software, getting a couple accepted shares already. So that's looking pretty good. Just to take a look at the overclocks for Ergo, so we have 2614 for the core clock, so pretty high on the core. Memory maxed out at 1900, okay, and then again running the fan at 61%. Percent, so that looks pretty good. You hear the card, it's pretty quiet, not too toasty in terms of the heat coming off of the card, so that looks pretty good. You have 55.87, 55.86, so sitting almost at that 56 mark in terms of hash rate. Let's again take a walk over to the wall and see what we have for the Ergo power limit here at the wall. And we're doing better than Ravencoin. We are sitting at 100, well, bouncing between 149 watts to, I saw a spike up to like 162, 163, but able to achieve underneath 150 watts, which is pretty cool at the wall. So yeah, let's take one last quick look at the hash rate. See if we got anything higher, any other variants. And nope, still sitting at the 55.87 mark, seems to be the steady mark, but pretty cool, impressive on the Ergo hash rate. So yeah, guys, this has been a cool, quick little test. So far, not bad numbers. The efficiency is pretty decent in terms of the power on this little guy. We are going to be interested to see what we get for results on the hanging rack. We're going to be hanging this thing up and we'll have five cards up there. We'll run a hash rate test on the card in HiveOS on the hanging rig to see what we get for hash rates and power efficiencies. And we will do all three of those algorithms. So we'll start with Ethereum and we'll go with Raven and then Ergo to finish. So yeah, my conclusion on this card so far is I really like the power efficiency. The price of the card itself was pretty decent, not too bad. So return on investment based off of the market, hopefully be around the 5 or 6 month mark on this card. And yeah, just pretty much easy to go, good on the power and decent on the mega hash. So we'll see if there's anyone out there that can kind of refine or come up with better clocks, or as these mining softwares improve, to see if things get a little bit better. I feel these cards have a little bit of unlocked or hidden potential, but we'll see where things ride. So Yeah, guys, let me know in the comments below. Have you been mining on the 6600s? What type of algorithms, what type of overclocks and efficiencies you've run? And most of all, if you like the video, please hit that thumbs up. Much appreciated. Hit that subscribe button so we can keep the channel content flowing and going. And yeah, with that said, we will see you on the next video. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.